This video will show you how to calculate a single point equilibrium in the iron-carbon system using the graphical mode of Thermo-Calc. The calculation can be run by anyone with a license for Thermo-Calc, including the free educational package. The calculation is based on example T1 of the examples included in your software, which you can access from the example files icon on the home screen, the Thermo-Calc folder, then double-click on example file T1. In this video, I will walk you step-by-step through setting up the calculation, but you can also customize it with your own settings. To begin, open Thermo-Calc in the graphical mode. The easiest way to create a single point equilibrium calculation is to use the template. Click the single point template from the home screen, and all the nodes you need for this type of calculation will appear in the project pane. We must configure each node. Start by selecting the system definer, where we'll set our database and elements. Click on the database drop-down menu and select the FE Demo database. If you're doing your own calculation, select the database you need. Next, select the elements iron and carbon. Make sure to select iron first so that it is the dependent element. The system is now defined, so click on the equilibrium calculator node to set the conditions. We are making a single point equilibrium calculation for an iron-carbon alloy at 1000 Kelvin. So we need to set temperature, pressure, system size, and composition. Based on the example, we will set the temperature to 1000 Kelvin. Set the pressure to 101,325 Pascal. Set the system size to 1 mole. For the composition, we only need to set one element, because the system size has been defined, making the other element dependent. Therefore, when we set carbon, iron will adjust automatically. Set carbon to 0.1 weight percent. You can change these amounts if you are working on your own calculation. You can also change the units for temperature, pressure, and so on, and you can change the composition unit. Make sure your values match mine before we move on. Next, we need to select our calculation type. Since we are using the single point template, single equilibrium is automatically selected. So you can leave this as it is. Our calculation is now configured, so click Perform Tree at the bottom center of the program. Once the calculation is complete, a table will appear in the visualizations window. Note that your results may vary slightly depending on the version you have. The top section of the table gives you information about the system, such as the mass, temperature, and the total Gibbs energy. Below that, you can see the stable phases. In this example, there are two, BCC and graphite. Here, you can see how much of each element you have in each phase. If you click on the composition drop-down menu, you can select the constitution, which will show you the models of the phase. Notice that you must change this for each phase. You may have noticed that we never configured the table renderer node. This is because a single point equilibrium calculation automatically provides you with a lot of information about your calculation. But you can view even more. Click on the table renderer node. Here you can add additional properties that you would like to view in the table. To do this, click the gray plus sign next to temperature. Click on the drop-down menu to see the list of properties that you can view. I will select thermal resistivity. Notice that it appeared at the top of the table immediately. You can add as many additional properties as you would like. You can also go back and change the configurations of your calculation at any time and run a new calculation. You can also add additional equilibrium calculators and table renderers if you want to create additional calculations and compare the results. Each calculation will receive a tab in the visualizations window. You can export the contents of the table into a text file or spreadsheet by right-clicking anywhere on the table and selecting Save As. You can also save the entire project to return to it later or share it with others by clicking File, Save Project As. If you liked this example, don't forget to press the like button and feel free to leave a comment about the type of video you'd like to see next. We are constantly working to create new examples, so make sure to subscribe to our channel so you don't miss out on any new videos. You can watch all of our videos at thermocalc.com in the video tutorials section.